Horizon's mission going to the Pluto system, it really is a system. It's a little mini solar system in its own right. We have not only Pluto, we also have a giant moon next to it, Charon.
When we first saw Pluto, Clyde Tombaugh first saw it and brought it to the world's attention, it was a mere dot.
Liquid particles, they can move around. Like when you jump in the pool, you're able to swim around.
It stayed a mere dot for a long time. In the 1970s, my stepfather, Jim Christy, kept looking at that dot.
I went to Bob Harrington and asked him if he had some scumple that I could do. And he reaches in his desk and pulls out an envelope from Flagstaff of Pluto. So I took the plates to a microscope and I started looking at the images.
As he was looking at them, he noticed that there was a bump on one of the sides of Pluto. He noticed that this bump seemed to move.
When I looked at the two that were a month apart, one had the asymmetry up and the other one had the asymmetry down.
He was very surprised. And then after the surprise, he got a little worried. Was he seeing things or was he actually seeing what he thought he saw? By looking at that and factoring that in, he deduced that something must be moving around Pluto, and therefore he was able to figure out that there was a satellite.
It was there that I realized that Pluto has a moon.
Well, I was at work when he called and he said, I think I'm going to be famous. I think I've discovered a moon.
Then I went and told Bob Harrington that Pluto has a moon. Bob said, Jim, you're crazy.
And then comes the big waiting game, having to get more evidence for that.
Jim did the measuring and Bob did the statistics, and they paralleled in their answers. He told me that he would try to name the moon after me if he could. And he just had made up the name Charon. Char is what my family call me. And he put the O-N onto the end of it.
I'm always thinking about physics, electrons, and protons. I added an O-N, and I thought I could name it Charon.
Now, when he came with that idea, he was a bit worried that maybe he bit off more than he could chew because he was worried about the International Astronomical Union approving something like that.
He got up, he was thinking, oh my gosh, you know, I hope to, I can name it after her, but I'm not sure. So anyway, he went to the find the dictionary.
And then what happened is one of the strangest events of my life. It'd be funny if I couldn't find it.
And so he got the dictionary out and he looked it up, and there it was in the dictionary, and it fit because it was within Greek mythology, and then it was accepted by the International Astronomical Union as Charon, the boatman to ferry the dead souls across the River Styx. I just feel so proud, and like I say, a lot of husbands promise their wives the moon, but he delivered.
And she has a big smile on her face when she says that.
3, 2, 1. We have ignition and liftoff of NASA's New Horizons spacecraft on a decade-long voyage to visit the planet Pluto and then beyond.
The whole world saw it for the first time, and all we had seen before was just a little fuzzy blur-like. And to be able to see it, it was just incredible.
There's a giant chasm encircling the equator of Charon that we think is a remnant of a water ice ocean that was just underneath its surface in the early days more than 4 billion years ago.
These are ice cliffs that are about 4 miles high. That's high. For a little moon, that's amazing.
It's kind of amazing when you think about it, you know, all that happened over the last 40 years.
While you're going from a little blur, which you actually don't see anything, to this enormous detail, it's a shock. And I wish I could see the other side.